Today's question comes from Willie F. in Chicago, Illinois, who wants to know, how does Google determine the canonical source for a piece of content? It's a really good question, and our answer to that has changed over time as we try to write new algorithms and find different ways of nailing down, you know, where was content originally written, where did it first appear. But let me sort of go through some of the signals that you could imagine us using. For example, the first time or the first place on the web that we saw content appear, right? If you happen to write something and publish it and we crawl it and we see all that content and then it shows up 2 years later somewhere else, well, it's more likely that the source is where we first saw it, you know, a couple years earlier. And you can even do things like if you have a blog or a content management system that can do a ping, you know, WordPress, Blogger, a lot of these sites, whenever you post a blog, whenever you actually you know, update or publish a blog post, you can send that ping, and that can go to various blog search and real-time search engines and to Google and that sort of thing. And that could maybe help narrow down the time at which some content was posted as well. Of course, there's PageRank. You know, if you see the exact same content and one really, really reputable site has it and one site that looks like it's brand new, fly-by-night, never seen it before, a little suspicious, not sure that it's highest quality, then, you know, you can imagine thinking, well, maybe it's more likely to show up on this more reputable site. Of course, there's rel canonical, which is a very implicit or very explicit signal that says this is the preferred location for this content. You can imagine slightly more indirect methods like rel equals author, which is a way that you can annotate the web and say, hey, I actually wrote this, or here's where my author profile page is. So you can sort of give a little bit of a hint about where content came from as far as the provenance and those sorts of things. There's also the idea of, you know, in theory, doing like site-level signals. Like if we think one particular site is scraping a whole lot, and then we see content show up on that site and another site, then maybe we're a little less likely to think that the scraper-esque looking type site is the original author compared to, you know, some other site that might have a good history of producing original content. So there's a lot of different factors you could think of. It can be tricky because Googlebot is effectively sampling the web. The web is infinite and it can change, you know, from millisecond to millisecond. And so it can be very tricky if you are crawling the web to find out exactly when and where content appeared first. We do try to do a good job of it. Sometimes we mess up and we're happy to get feedback about when we do, but it's definitely the case that there are a lot of different hints and signals and potential ways that you can try to figure out what the canonical or original source for some particular content is.